So let's talk about the RSV virus and the RSV vaccine today. Of all children less than 1 year of age, about 68% of them are going to be infected by this virus in the RSV season, which runs from October of 1 year to March of the upcoming year. So this is really important for us to talk about today. Hi, this is Dr. Beatty of the Newborn Prep Academy and also a pediatrician at Partners in Pediatrics and Family Health. And again, like I said, let's talk about the RSV disease and the RSV vaccine because it's really important. So the RSV stands for respiratory syncytial virus. It's one of those viruses that you have about this time of year. So running from about October of 1 year to March of the following year. It is a virus you have, you know, during the cold season, and it affects all ages. So newborns all the way up to the elderly. Now, of all these ages, newborns who are, especially when they're a few months old and certainly in that first year of life, and also the very elderly, you know, over 60, 65 years of age, seem to be those that are hardest hit when they get infected with the virus. Although lots of, it actually accounts for most of the admissions for respiratory viruses in the infant years. So for children who are less than 1 year of age, when you look at all the admissions for respiratory viruses, the RSV virus usually accounts for a majority of those admissions. So it is not, you know, it is a serious condition to look at because, again, young kids and elderly get hit very hard oftentimes with the virus. And what it does, the virus attacks the airway, kind of destroys the airway and causes a lot of inflammation and mucus buildup, which makes it very difficult for our infants or elderly to breathe easily. And so they have a lot of respiratory distress that requires a lot of support to be able to make it through that infection. It is a virus, so there isn't some treatment for it that actually treats the virus itself. All we can do is support the child or adult while they're going through this infection until the body can take care of it. And a number of times this requires being admitted to the hospital, having some oxygen support, some breathing support. Sometimes they're having to really do some intense respiratory support to make it through that infection. So these are reasons why it's really very important for us to look at protecting our vulnerable population. So that'll be infants and the elderly with the RSV vaccine. So like I said, it does affect all ages. And so you'll have, you know, school age kids who come down with the virus. But for the most part, most of those kids end up just having a very bad cold. But again, not as much for the younger ones and the elderly. Now, something that's important to note is that when you look at all children who are admitted with for the RSV infection, about 79%, so almost 80% of those children don't really have some other serious medical condition going on. So what this means is that you really can't tell who is going to end up having a really bad infection that requires admission. So it's not like you can say, well, all the kids who have asthma and all the kids who have heart disease are only the ones who get admitted. Certainly, those children and those babies are at a higher risk for bad outcomes or for, you know, serious disease requiring admission. But there are also many, many, many very healthy babies who end up with the RSV infection and are hit very hard and require admission as well. So what can you do? So what you can do is protect your young one, your infant, with the RSV virus, vaccine rather. And this vaccine, what it does is help your body build immunity or build antibodies that can fight against the RSV virus when you are infected or when your baby is infected with the virus. There are a number of different vaccines depending on the age of the patient. So you have vaccines that are for the elderly. And in this context, I'm going to talk about vaccines for our pregnant women, and so those will be women who are 32 to 36 weeks pregnant, and it's advised that you get vaccinated against the RSV virus. So first of all, it protects you from getting the increases your protection against the RSV infection virus, so you're better protected from getting infected with the virus and having really bad lung disease, as well as passing on some protection to your unborn infant as well, as long as you get it about at least two weeks or so before delivery. It is in your baby about 64% effective, as opposed to when your baby does get the vaccine itself, it can be as high when they've done the studies. The effectiveness of preventing disease, bad disease with RSV, has been as high as 90%. So it's actually quite effective when it comes to helping your baby fight off the RSV infection. When you get it as a pregnant mom, it does give protection to your unborn infant, to your baby when they're born, for about 6 months. What infants are recommended to get a vaccine? It's going to be all infants of 8 months and younger who are entering into their first RSV season or are in their first RSV season. So at the time of recording this video, it's November, second week in November. And so we are in the RSV season right now, and we're going to start having more and more cases as the months progress, like I said, all through March. And sometimes that can even go beyond March. Last year, I think we had a few RSV cases beyond March, but that's the typical season. It goes through March of the following year. So this is the best time to go ahead and get your infant who is 8 months old and younger vaccinated with the RSV vaccine. It is a safe vaccine. Most of the side effects are going to be very mild ones, like just irritation and swelling in the area where the vaccine was given, maybe a little bit of a fever. But in my experience, given the vaccine so far in the office, most of our, the vast majority of our infants have done really well. And I can't even think of anyone that's really had a bad outcome or bad reaction to it, not even like high fevers. They've all really done pretty well. And so I really want to encourage you to consider getting the RSV vaccine for your infant who's 8 months and younger, who are entering who are in their first RSV season. And the vaccine also is actually indicated also for infants who are 8 months to about 19 months old, who are entering their second RSV season if they have a high risk condition, so like a cardiac condition or some serious respiratory condition that puts them at a high risk. And so they can actually get the vaccine again when they're entering the second RSV season. So I hope this has been helpful to give you some more information so you can be informed and make the right decision for yourself if you're pregnant and you're 32 weeks to 36 weeks, or if you have a baby who's 8 months or less in this first RSV season, or maybe you even have a child who is 8 months to 19 months who has a high risk condition and they're entering into their second RSV season. Again, this is Dr. Beattie of the Newborn Prep Academy and pediatrician at Partners in Pediatrics and Family Health. If you're in the Washington County, Maryland area, we would love to be able to care for your newborn or for you as an adult, or if you have children. We are a family practice caring for both adults and kids. Just call the office at 301-791-7060. And make sure you share this video with a friend or family member who would love to hear about the RSV vaccine. And thank you for watching this, and we'll see you again some other time.